Preparations are being made in selected schools for the return of students despite the pandemic. Education Secretary Leonor Briones said, based on studies, there is a lower chance for children to contract COVID-19 in classes compared to other areas.
Ang pinakamababang rate ng infection globally at saka sa atin din dito sa Pilipinas ay sa school. Kasi ngayon, wala naman tayong face-to-face. Malaking bahagi ay sa mga homes, sa transport. Kaya hindi pwedeng magpatuloy tayo maski low risk kung ang ibang factor ay hindi natin nakoconsider, lalo na local government at parents. Dahil the children spend most of their time at home.
In the recommendation of Briones for limited face-to-face classes, which was based on the global evidence presentation of UNICEF Philippines, only 1 to 5% of total reported cases are children or adolescents. 91% of COVID cases among children are from household exposure.
While there is a risk, children do transmit the disease. Schools can be a place in which transmission happens. They do not appear to be the main driver of spikes in transmission. So for example, Germany has been able to do that. South Korea, as you may know, never closed.
However, in the presentation of WHO Philippines to DepEd, there is a higher incidence of asymptomatic positive cases among children. There is also inadequate evidence for transmission in school settings. For a pediatric infectious disease specialist, the DOH should present actual studies about COVID-19 transmission in schools.
Ngayon pa lang tayo nagsimula magpapasok ng mga bata sa eskwelahan. So medyo maaga pa para mag-conclude, no, na hindi kasing laki yung impact ng pagkalat sa school kumpara sa pagkalat sa bahay. Kasi syempre, ano ba yung database na ating pinagkukumparahan?
The resumption of face-to-face classes has drawn mixed reactions.
Kung yun yung dapat, di ba?
Hindi ako pabor doon. Wala pang vaccine eh.
The Department of Education said the responsibility of ensuring the safety of students should not fall on the agency alone. Local government units and parents also play a huge part in minimizing the risks of infection.
They will require the children to wear face mask and face shield.
This is a decision, difficult decision, which has trade-offs. But what should not be a difficult decision is to do everything we can to safeguard the future of the next generation.
There are over 1,000 schools nominated by regional directors for the dry run of face-to-face classes in January next year. Briones says the final list of schools that will be picked to participate in the dry run will undergo strict evaluation. Ara Perez, ABS-CBN News.